Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Earlier in the week, SpaceX launched another batch of Starlink satellites with the Starlink 436 mission.
One mission and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1062, then landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
The first stage is traveling near the speed of sound as it's transitioning through the Earth's atmosphere. Its landing burn to start in about 20 seconds, followed shortly after by landing leg deploy, and around that same time we'll hear a call out for second engine cutoff on the second stage.
Landing burn.
So the first stage has lit one engine to prepare for landing on our drone ship, aimed a shortfall of gravitas on the right-hand side of your screen.
Landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
And back shutdown.
Acquisition of signal to Finland.
So a few things called out there. First, Falcon 9 has landed. That marks the 40th landing of this year, 141st overall landing of a Falcon 9 first stage.
I know it's a tad bit early, but given how excited everybody is to see the next Falcon Heavy launch, I wanted to share the latest info. I believe the next Falcon Heavy launch in about a week is still on track to launch then. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of Falcon Heavy USSF 44 is scheduled for next week on Monday 31st at 10:44 a.m. UTC or 6:44 a.m. EDT. Elon Musk posted a tweet about the Starlink launch saying, "Congrats to SpaceX team on 48th launch this year. Falcon 9 now holds record for most launches of a single vehicle type in a year." There was an article posted about ESA giving SpaceX more launches for their Falcon 9 vehicle. It says the European Space Agency now plans to launch a space telescope and an asteroid mission on Falcon 9 rockets because of its loss of access to Soyuz vehicles and delays in the introduction of the Ariane 6. At an October 20th press briefing after a meeting of the ESA Council, ESA Director General Joseph Aschbacher said the agency had decided to launch the Euclid Astrophysics mission on a Falcon 9 in 2023 and Hera an asteroid mission in 2024. Heading to Boca Chica, work continued on Ship 25 inside the high bay. During the week, the Starship 25 prototype was rolled out to the launch site. The crane at the suborbital launch site was hooked up to Ship 25. Ship 25 was also lifted onto the suborbital Pad A test mount for proof testing. During the week, the Ship 24 prototype was lifted back onto Booster 7 again. SpaceX posted this awesome video on Twitter of Ship 24 being restacked on Booster 7. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are a whole bunch of dates. There are currently possible closures for every day this coming week, starting with tomorrow, Monday 24th. Then there are possible closures for Tuesday 25th, Wednesday 26th, Thursday 27th and Friday 28th. The final thing to take a look at for this video is an updated Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, thank you to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content too. Plus, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.